Hello, and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we are looking at the fourth grade concept of shapes, specifically how we can classify different types of triangles based on their angles, and we'll do it in 5 minutes or less. So you see three very basic triangles on the screen. And the first thing that we are going to look at is this top left triangle. And this is what we call a right triangle, and this is going to be our basis of comparison for all the other triangles we're looking at. Because when we're looking at triangles, one way, not the only way, but one way to classify them is based on their angles. And these are the spaces in between the corners here. And you see, this corner right here is a square corner because it is perpendicular. So when we're talking about perpendicular, that's a big word. That means we have one line that goes straight up and down, one line that goes straight side to side. It's the square corner right here. And this corner, we're going to call it a few different things. It has an angle name, so we call it a right angle. That's why we call it a right triangle, because we're always looking at the largest angle within a triangle. We use that to name the triangle. So the largest angle within this triangle is the right angle. So we're going to call this a right triangle because it has these perpendicular lines. This one right here is perpendicular to this one right here. Another way to think about this, though, is this is a 90-degree angle. One way to think about degrees is if you think of a circle, and if you start up here at the very top, and you go all the way around, so you draw a little line right here, and then you move this line all the way around like this, you can measure the movement of that line in degrees. And the entire circle is 360 degrees. If you've ever played a skateboarding game or a snowboarding game, you know that when you make one complete flip, that's called a 360. If you start in your front and you flip to the back, that's called a 180. Because 180 degrees is halfway around. You start in the front and then you move just halfway. So 90 degrees is going to be half of that. So 180 is half of 360. And so 90 is going to be right here. This is 90. Because really when you're thinking about a circle, you're skip counting by 90s. You've got 90, you've got 180. This over here is 270. And then you've got your 360. But this 90 degrees forms a right angle. Another way to think of the right angle is this is the angle that your floor and your walls, and that's they meet at. It's the right angle. And thankfully it is, because if it was the wrong angle, your floor and your wall would not work and your wall would fall down. For it to stay up, it needs to be at the exact right angle with one straight up and down, one side to side. So this is a right angle or a 90 degree angle, and that's why we call this a right triangle. Now, if you look at this triangle, we're going to call this an acute triangle because the largest angle in this triangle, and it's probably, honestly, I'm not sure. All three of these look very similar. I know they're not exactly the same, but they look very similar. These are all acute angles. And acute angles are anything that are smaller than 90. So acute angles, I'm going to say, are less than 90 degrees. So this is a smaller angle than a perpendicular angle, right angle. All three of these are. That's why we're going to call this an acute angle. So we have first an acute angle is going to be less than 90. And then we've got a right angle that is exactly 90. So you're probably thinking, well, what do we call something that is larger than 90? That's this angle right here. This is an obtuse angle. Obtuse angles are greater than 90 degrees. And you can see that that's a really big, fat angle. And so that's going to be our largest angle. That's going to be obtuse. And so that is going to be larger than 90 degrees, which means we are going to call this an obtuse triangle. So one way to name these triangles is by the name of their largest angle. So if you have a perpendicular 90-degree angle, it's a right triangle. If you have all three angles that are smaller than that 90 degrees, it's going to be an acute triangle. And then if you have a big, fat angle, it's going to be an obtuse triangle.